with Madden 19 being pretty much over after the Madden Bowl, a number one thing that everybody wants to know now is what's going to be happening with Madden 20 Ultimate Team. Now, we already have some insight into it. The game is going to be dropping August 2nd. We already know that you can get the game 3 days early. We know about the Superstar Edition, and we know about the Ultimate Superstar Edition. But there's also other things that they've already detailed about some of the things that you're going to need to do and why it's more important. And we're going to go over those things right now. Pretty much what happens is this, right? There are three type of players in Madden 19 Ultimate Team. There's the dudes that buy the packs. They don't care what's going on. Bro, look, I got my rent due. My baby need diapers. I don't care. It is what it is. I'm still buying packs. There's the dudes that grind. Yo, it don't matter. I got schoolwork to do. I don't care what my mom says. I don't care what my wife says. Like, it don't really matter. I'm grinding. Then there are dudes that do both, okay, which is very, very unique, and it's a hybrid. It's like, all right, you know what? I'm not going to pay the water bill because they don't need water this month. I'm going to go do this. I'm going to get this pack right quick. And then also, yeah, I know the baby's crying in the other room, but I'm going to sit here and finish this solo. So the grinders and the packers, and then they got the packers, and then you got the dudes that just grind, all right? This is what I've gotten from the EA Sports website about Madden 20 so far. Like I told you, they got the standard, they got the superstar, and they got the ultimate superstar. Now, the ultimate superstar gives you a little bit more around the packs and, you know, choosing specific chemistries and abilities for specific players and all that crap like that. We'll get into that in another video. One of the interesting things that I saw that I read, though, is the fact that they're going to make solo challenges and objectives and mutt level a lot more important. So what does that mean for all of us, right? Whether you're a pack buyer or not, it looks like they're going to be forcing you to play solos the way that they did this year also and prior in order to unlock certain things easier. Now, remember, for the most part, you guys can always just play a lot of games. You guys can play a lot of games and, you know, you can get your level up like that and then unlock other things. And what I'm talking about is the mutt level in the top right. That's the red 90. You can do different things to unlock that. But it's much easier to get comfortable with the game and learn it more by doing solos and trying to get that under your belt. Now, remember this, guys. A lot of the things that go into the game is based off of your objectives that you have to complete. Now, there's no news on the Mutt Master or how they're going to do that or anything of that nature right now. But this is something that I want to make sure that you guys are very, very aware of. Whether you like to buy packs or whatever you're doing, none of that matters anymore. All right? They're going to make it so that the actual streamlined process of getting through daily solos is more important than ever. And that's actually written and stated. So we're going to have to figure out exactly how much more of that, you know, how serious are they about that? Like, is that something that's absolutely necessary in order to make everything go smoothly with your game? We're going to have to figure that out. Like, that's something that we're going to have to look to. But I want to make sure that you guys are familiar with everything that's going on as we continue to pursue it, because Mutt Master, obviously, with this year, the way that they did it, you didn't have to do online games to get Mutt Master for the first year ever, all right? So pretty much what they're saying is they're going to be catering to both the people that don't like to go online and the online players alike, again, for another consecutive year, which is something that I actually like as well, because if you feel more comfortable not dealing with stuff online, that's also cool, bro. Like, you should be able to get the same things. It should take you a lot longer. Well, not a lot longer, but you should have to do more. Because obviously, when you're playing against human opponents, it's a little bit more difficult than already knowing what the CPU is doing and things of that nature. So that's something that I agree with, to allow people both ways to be able to get it done. Everybody gets their Mutt Master. Everybody's happy. All right? But in doing that, you take away a lot from the people that do both. Because right now, I just want to point this out to you. Because some of you guys even mentioned this, which is what gave me the idea for the video. You're like, Gmaya, yeah, they're talking about all this stuff in Madden 20, but we still don't know what we're doing with certain collectibles. Why haven't they given us anything with these Shazier collectibles? What's going on? That's a very, very good question. Listen, I don't know how to, you know, pretty much what happens is this, right? Is it under this? Okay, it's not under that. So what is, do they have Mutt Master here, or is it just collectibles we have to go under? Because it might be under that, because I don't know where I could find it from. Okay, Master. Here it is right here. So look, with things like this, right, they have yet to give us anything for it. So it's like, yo, what are they doing? What are they talking about? Like, we're going to have to go through this grind and be able to do this. And they still, when we did both of them, like we did it offline and for online, and we got additional stuff, they still haven't given us anything for it. And it's so late in the year. We only got 3 months. It's the second year in a row they're doing it. You guys are raging at me. I don't know what to tell you. Because I agree, a lot of these things that we got in duplicate, They should have given us other ways to utilize it. So this is a concern of mine. Are they going to have it sequential in a format to where you can actually get something else during the time when it actually matters? Instead of just having this now and then you give it to us like, all right, yeah, it's a month before, you know, Madden 20. Here you go, guys. Like, nobody's really playing Madden like that. You know, that late when we know the other one is coming out very soon. So, you know, with the context in the which, in the way that they put it, for, you know, the solos are going to matter more than ever. That's going to be a guideline to what you're going to be doing, your objectives and progress, all that stuff. Doing it both ways, like, what are we doing here? I understand the solo format and everything like that, but they do need to give us something at the time. Like, can you imagine? Say they gave us even a chance at, like, 100,000 coins. Like, you know, the way they did with the additional captain tokens. I think a lot of us would have been happy about that early in the year. All right, you did both. All right, here goes your chance from 10K to 100K early in the year to give us a chance at that kind of coins. That's, you know, that's a simplistic idea that I think that a lot of you guys would be happy with. Let me know. For the guys that did Muttmaster both sides, you did it with offline and online, and you still have additional cards. Would that be something that would, you know, early in the year, with your chance to get those coins that everybody is dying to get, would that have helped your whole situation a lot more? I really think it would have helped me personally. I like the fact that they give you, you know, 250K for completing it or whatever kind of crap. But remember, they used to give you a mil. I did it in Madden 15. Check my videos right here on YouTube. Check Madden 15 Muttmaster. When I did, you were getting like a mil, I think, right? For like when it first started. Then it just started getting lower and lower and lower. So if they're going to do that, they need to give us opportunities to get even more coins. Like, I think they gave us 250 and then 750. But you have to, like, complete additional Muttmaster objectives with Ryan Shazier to get it. So you're still getting it, but they're making you work a lot more for it. And it's like, bro, after I do Muttmaster, I didn't put in so much work. Like, leave me alone, dog. Like, what is this even about? But those are just some things that I wanted to point out, because you guys have specifically asked those questions. And I like to address it just so that you know I am listening. But it's a lot of you guys asking questions. And, I'm trying to get to as many as I can. And then hopefully throughout the chat, we can help each other out to kind of figure out what's going on in between the lines. But again, the benefits of playing offline and utilizing the solos, they're stressing that it's going to be more important than ever. So I just want to make sure that you guys point that out, as far, you know, that I pointed it out to you guys. With the whole situation with sets, no information right now is ready for that. We don't know a lot about the way that it's going to be formatted, but I can tell you this based on what's going on. They're more than likely, based on what they said, there's going to be a campaign mode again, just based on what they wrote, campaign, the new additions to the campaign mode, all that stuff. So you will be seeing this in some format where they'll be helping you to get those cards. You remember, like, a lot of us got the Joey Bosa, Deion Jones, Telvin, you know, Marcus Peters early. They're going to give you an opportunity through playing solos and blasting through it to be able to get free cards at the launch of the year. That already has been, you know, they pretty much gave us hints to it. You know, it's going to be a different campaign, better than ever, all that crap. So that stuff is going to be going on, all right? So look out for that stuff. And again, if you guys are buying packs, remember, at the launch, I believe that more than likely they're going to do something similar to how they did with the Team Diamonds, right? So the highest overall at that time is probably going to be, remember this, right? When the game was launched and this, like, it was a few people, like, after, like, a month or something, they were running around with this guy to 94. Other than him, I think the highest was maybe, like, a 90, maybe 91, possibly. So, more than likely, they're going to do something like this. So, I'm not saying that even with the information that they're giving us about going that route with campaign and the solos being more important than ever with building your team, that that's going to be a necessity. You can easily buy packs and just complete whatever's there. They're going to always have that outlet. You're going to always have an opportunity to get a player of a higher overall, but you're going to have a lot of work to do. And it's going to be very, very expensive. And that's just something that most people, you know, like when MLB first launches and a guy spends $2,000 and their team is unstoppable, the only thing about it is with this, we don't know how the players are going to actually react on the field. If we knew that the players were going to play up to their par as far as, you know, what their stats say, there would be no issue with the game. There would absolutely be no issue with it. But because we don't know how it's going to play out, that's going to be the only deciding factor. So I want to point out to you guys that, yeah, for those guys that are just packers, which is what I call guys that just buy packs, they don't care about nothing, I call you guys packers, you're going to still have a sick team without playing any solos, regardless of what EA is talking about, yeah, you're going to need this. But But keep this in mind. It is much easier for your daily objectives if you just bang out two solos. You see what I'm saying? Like, if you don't, if you want to just keep it like nickel and dime it, just keep it 100. If you just play your two solos, you know, complete a set, buy something from the store, it's much easier to just do that offline before having to jump into an actual game and go through all that. So that's just another thing that you guys should keep in mind. Also, the campaign players, more than likely they're going to be Nats, but I don't know how they're going to format it. We do know that training is going to be in the game because they speak about in the Ultimate Superstar Edition giving you training points for free for, you know, a certain amount, whatever, if you get that edition. And that's another thing also. I want to know the edition that you guys are going after. Are you guys going after the Ultimate Superstar Edition or just the Superstar Edition? Or are you guys just going straight dirt bag cheap and you're just going to go for the Standard Edition? Like, let me know, bro. Like, just let me know what you're doing right now, because you already know I'm buying 17,000 of the game regardless of how bad it is. I don't really care. I just want to know what you guys are thinking about that. But that's some of the new information, but I just want to make sure that as we're preparing for it, that you guys remember that I told you. It doesn't really matter what they're saying about, yeah, this and that. It matters how you're going to make it work for your team. So if you're more of a grinder, you're going to, you know, it's more geared, like with this campaign for you, stuff like that. If you're a Packer, dog, like Packers, you guys are still good as well. So regardless of what they're saying, either way, we're going to all triumph. The best of both worlds, though, is like the way I do it. I grind, and earlier in the year, I was buying packs. I just refused to buy packs as of 3 months ago. But that doesn't mean that at the launch of Madden 20, if they release a demo, you know what I'm saying? And the demo is playing kind of fire, that I won't mess around and buy a bundle at launch, dog. Like, you guys got to let me know right now. You guys want a bundle at the launch of Madden 20? Bro, I'll just, yeah, hey, I'll plan for it. You guys know how I do, bro. I'll be dropping them stacks, like stacks on stacks on stacks, packs on packs on packs, if that's what you guys want. You got to let me know, though. As more information is released about Madden Ultimate Team, I will be giving it to you guys like I'm not going to say it. That might have been inappropriate, but I'm going to be giving it to you guys, though. You know what I'm saying? You guys know what I'm saying. For most of my real ones, you know what I was trying to say. And that's pretty much what I'm going to leave you guys with. And also, let me know, are you excited about Madden 20? Are you not buying Madden 20? Do you think it's all gimmicks, whatever? Give me all your feedback. But like I always tell you guys, we got to wait to see how it turns out. Because from Madden 09 to Madden 10, that was night and day. I'm going to see you guys and girls next time. One love.